Afternoon, everybody. As you know, this is part two of the A10 Warhog. And what I wanted to do is show you how I did the lights before I close it up, get ready to do my sanding, do my putty fill and all that, because once I start, I can't go back in and show you how I did the lights. So what I want to do is let you look at it, let you see it, and then take it apart and show you how I did the lights and what I used. So I'm going to take the camera and we'll shine it down on the lights on the Corsair here, or the Warhog, and let you see it. Now, this is just taped up, so don't look at it and go, wow. What you see here, turn this light up, okay? In the front, we got a cockpit light. Out on the wings, we got fast flashers. On the top here, we got a yellow beacon. And then that piece you see down here is the landing gear with the wire taped up, because I haven't got it all put back together. But that's what it'll look like lit up. And what I wanted to show you is how I did it and what I did and the stuff I used. I hope you guys like this video. Again, subscribe if you do. And anyway, we won't go into that. Let me pull the camera up and I'll start taking it apart and showing you all what I did. How I did this. Number one, all this is ran off of a 9-volt battery. All of it, okay? You only see two wires, and that's my power source. And everything I used is pretty simple. So it's not like you need a genius to do it, but it's it takes some time. And then, you have to like it because it's tedious. Try to take the tape off so I can open the canopy back up for y'all. Alright. As you see here, right here, these right here are small 3 millimeter red lights. And what we've done is we wired them in here and we ran them, okay? Our lights out on the edge are just plain LED nano lights, small nano lights. And as you can see, we ran our wire up through here. Now, damn, if I didn't want that to come off, it would all came off easy. Anyway. As you see, they're wired up. Now, I didn't use shrink wrap on this because it would have been too tight going into the area there. So what I did is I used liquid tape, okay? Now, on the other side, okay, as you can see, and this is not glued up in there, so that's why I just used the tape. We're using a small chipboard to light everything up, okay? And I'll go ahead and take that apart and let you see it. The cockpit has a small LED light in there. I don't know if you can see it. Let me help you. Down in the bottom, I've mounted it up underneath the hang on here. Let you see it. See here? It's mounted up underneath the dash or the console, so you can see that. I didn't want it to illuminate the whole place. Down here, as you see, that's one of the two lights that light up. This one's at the top. The bottom is showing right there at the bottom. And it'll illuminate the top light up here. Then on our wings, they're flashing lights, okay? And as you can see, they're a high rate flash. So that is just to show you now. We're using the board, okay? And your board has these plugs, if you see them right here, four different leads. That's what everything is wired into. Now, when we put this all together, I'll be gluing this. I'm not gonna leave it like this, but I'll be gluing it in there. And you have your power in, which is one. You have your four of them on there. Now, let me take this apart. Show you all right quick. That's what it looks like. It's just a small board. Let me turn on the light in here in the room. All right, that's better. I didn't want all the light to show you the... anyway, that's what it looks like, okay? And this is what to use. The leads, okay? That's all they are, is leads. And they plug into here. Pretty self-explanatory. Just like that. Okay. Now, these lights out here on the end of the wing are just plain white LED lights. They're nano LED lights. On your board here, I don't know if you can see it. You see the letters at the top. 2X, 1X, FL, SB. Now, the 2X, which is running the tips of the wings, that is a double quick flash and pause. You saw what that does. The ones on the top, the red ones on top, are 3mm LEDs. They're running a single flash and a pause. Okay? Up underneath there for where our landing gear is going to be for the front, we're using FL, which is, it's just a standard slow flash, like a beacon light is all they are. The ones at the top or the light is a beacon. Some people want them just bright light. Some people want them just flashing. I wanted to use flashing. Our cockpit is SB5B. Got to remember which one I used. Anyway, it's for cockpits. It's just a, all that is a little, right here. It's a small, small 3-volt golden yellow light. That's all that is. It's a small, that's what it is. Just a small light. Now, show you on here. I tried this for the first time with this kit because I had a tight area and I didn't want to have a big gob of wire, even though it looks like it. But once you get it all tightened up, cleaned up, it'll look fine. Once I get the kit put together, you'll see. The wire I'm using is a 24 gauge magnetic wire. Okay, and you saw what it does. Now the thing, reason I like magnetic wire is you go and use small wire and you try to strip it, I have trouble. I cut it trying to strip it because I close it and it's too much. Anyway, with a magnetic wire, okay, you can take a cigarette lighter, burn the tip of it, and it melts off the coating. So much easier, burns off the coating. Then you can wire it up, and as you see there, let me show you all right quick. I'm trying to show you stuff instead of just saying it. I know how you are, but that's the way I work. I want to see the stuff work. I don't want to hear how the clock was made. I want to see how it's worked, you know. I want to see it work. And as you see, these tips have been, you can't see it. I'm not going to waste your time, say, as you can see. That's what that is in there. That's what is in the cockpit. Okay? Small beacon light. Okay? Now, that's all I use. But, with this wiring, that's what I used in the cockpit right here. Is, a small wiring and it fit up in there just snug as can be. I really like it. I'm impressed with it. The other thing is, these here, I think I might have mentioned it, are just regular white lights. But using this board, what I've done is took a white light and made it a flasher. Okay? Now, with this board, you have your flasher, the first one. Excuse me. You can hook up up to 5 different lights to it, to that one plug. So, in other words, I can take 5 lights and hook them into this and plug it into here, and it'll run 5 lights, okay? So, I have a kit and I want to put 5 different areas of flashing lights, I can do it that way. The next one the same. Each one will take up to 5, okay? Now, on the lighting up top here, they're these here. They're 3 millimeter LED, but the thing is, if you want to use a red, you gotta look it up anyway. If you look up resistors and all that, it'll tell you, but I'll explain it to you much easier. The red doesn't use as much power, so if you don't have a resistor in there, it's gonna blow it right away. So add a resistor to your red light. Say you wanna run red, blue, white, yellow, whatever, right? Put resistors in there, or as soon as you power it up, it'll light once and it'll just blow up. It'll just blow out. It won't work no more. And when you've done a whole kit, you start using words that you can't use. But that's what you gotta remember, okay? Now, you don't have to use flashing lights with this board. You can use regular lights. If you don't wanna use the board, that's fine. You can make your own board like I showed you in my other videos, the board I made, and I just put flashing lights in there. But the reason I tried this board is I can hook up more than one thing and it can all do different functions and not have to re-solder everything. See what I'm saying? But anyway, that's pretty much. I wanted to show you this. It looks like a mess. I mean, look at this right now. Yeah. You look and you go, holy shit, fire, save the matches. It's not that big a deal, okay? It's not that big a deal. Don't be alarmed and you know, get all wired up. What was I gonna say? I've taped a lot of this because once I put it all together, start doing my gap filling in and my sanding, I can't take it apart and show you. That's why I want to do this one time. Show you what I did and how I hooked them all up. Hopefully it helps. I do a lot of LEDs because I want to encourage it. Everybody says, well, I'm not that patient. I'm not. Let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you straight up. I am not patient. I have the tolerance of that much. Not that. So if I can do it, y'all can do it. And it adds to your kits. You want to add a little bit of light inside a tank. Very easy. Add a little dome light in there or something. You want to add a light inside your car. Take one of these or the other board I showed you, I made. You can put it in the trunk and light up the inside of your car and look great. Now, all of this is heading to one kit, okay, that I'm fixing to start here. I don't know when, but this is all trial and error to start on one kit. And that's a tow truck, a 125 scale big rig truck. And I want to use, anyway. People who know me from when I first started models, I loved stowage on everything. I was a stowage freak, okay? Well, now I'm an LED freak. Anyway, enough babbling. I hope this video helped. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. And give it a try, you guys. You guys do some great work. I see what you guys do. Give it a try. Try some LEDs. Shoot, you can get this dirt cheap on Amazon. And the wire, simple. Just like me, you guys spend more on cable bills, I bet. Anyway, all right, I hope you enjoyed the video. Next time I talk to y'all, I'll have it together. and sanded and probably primered, and we'll go from there. Friday, go Georgia Bulldogs this weekend. Y'all have a great weekend. Be safe out there. Later.